Hello everyone, I welcome you all to this YouTube channel of Zoological Society of Assam. Here today I am going to present a PowerPoint presentation on the topic ecotone and edge effect. The topic is one of the most important part of ecology. Also, I am very much thankful to the Zoological Society of Assam for giving me a chance to present the topic. The topic will cover the following learning outcome. It will define the terminology of ecotone and edge effect. To understand the diversity of two or more different ecosystems adjacent nearby. To study the impacts of edge effect, types of ecotone, patterns of biodiversity in an ecotone. Importance of ecotone and its management. It will give better understanding about the characters and role of ecotone. Also, it will give a better understanding on the gene flow and ecotone as an indicator of the climate change in a particular area. So at first, let us define the term ecotone. As you know, the word ecotone is Greek in origin. It has two parts, eco and the tones. The eco, it is coming from the oikos, means home, and tones, it comes from the tonos, which means tension. It was first described in the year 1905 by Clemens as tension zones, where the principal species from adjacent communities meet their limits. The importance was further stressed by Odum that the ecotones are the transition zones between the two different communities in two different ecosystems. So here in this figure we can see the transition zone formation, that is in between the two ecosystems. One is artificial and the another one is the natural. And there is a diversity which is found to be higher in the ecotone zone, and that's how the importance of the ecotone is more, because ultimately it increases the landscape diversity of a particular ecosystem. And we talk about the ecotone, the transition zone, it is in between the two different ecosystems. Another definition of ecotone has been given as that the ecotone is situated where there is a change in the nature of ecological transfers with comparison to the changes in the interior patches that is found in a particular ecosystem. And basically, ecotones have species in common with both adjacent interior communities, as well as they have the edge specialist species. This includes the boundary region, borders, meeting zones, transitional zones, tension zones, zones of intermingling, and zones of transcription. All the zones are the zones where the species it mix together. The definition often contrasts ecotones with more homogeneous area found on both sides of the transition or to the landscape as a whole. And the ecotones can occur in both terrestrial and aquatic systems and cover several spatial scales, from large spatial scale ecotones where the biomes meet to local scale transitions such as mountain tree lines. These areas are sometimes considered to be more dynamic zones because of the interaction of different communities, and it is found to be unstable over time. In the figure, as we have seen, the different ecosystem, that is from the forest ecosystem to the grassland ecosystem, there is a disturbance. It is showing there in the diagram, and there is a transition zone. It is formed in between the two ecosystems, and it has been found that in between these two ecosystems, the transition zone that has been found or the ecotone it has been formed, it has a very dynamic activity of different species, as well as transfer of different types of nutrients, as well as physicochemical these materials are taking places. So these ecotones can be regarded as the most dynamic places in the whole area in comparison to the other two ecosystems. And the ecotone, which leads to the formation of edge effect. As we know, ecotones are commonly defined as the transition zone between adjacent ecosystems. Because of the wetlands, tree lines, and the meeting of the savanna and the desert are all examples of ecotones. Ecotones sometimes called edges. Why it is called as edges? Because it is in the boundary line. Frequently, it is supported by a comparatively large amount of diversity of certain species, and also it is a dynamic area of activity, and which leads to the huge biomass. When such phenomena it occurs in a particular zone or a transition zone, it is known as edge effect. The edge effect is accounted for by the simple fact that the ecotone supports many of the species from each of the overlapping communities. In addition, there are species which are characteristics of and often restricted to the ecotone. And it has been found that because of the edge effect, a large group of communities or the species that are found in a particular ecosystem are very species specific or region specific. It is restricted to that particular ecotone. So the edge effect can be defined as an edge is the boundary or the junction between two biological communities having different elements of an area. It refers to the changes taking place in population or community structure due to the ecotonal impact at the boundary. Is the edge effect is the changes that is taking place in the community structure in a particular ecotone. We have seen the effect that is occurring in a particular ecotonal area. In the figure, we have seen the ecosystem A and the ecosystem B, and the species diversity in the A and B is much lower in compared to the transition zone or the ecotone, which results in the increase in the species diversity. This phenomena is known as edge effect. And in the figure 5, we have seen it is the transition zone where the species coming from the both the forest ecosystem as well as it is from the grassland ecosystem, ultimately they are found in the transition zone for a longer period of time. So ultimately that edge effect it occurs. Now next is the impacts of edge effect. As we know, the increase in diversity and productivity in an ecotone is known as edge effect. Generally, the edge effect it impacts on the ecotone. At the edge of the two overlapping ecosystems, we can find the unique species and the species from both the ecosystems. Also, it impacts on the temperature, humidity, soil moisture, and light intensity levels, which are changing at the edges. At the edge, the increased plant diversity increases the primary consumers, which results in the increase in the secondary consumers, and ultimately it increases the tertiary consumers. The edges act as energy nets which capture the massive movements of materials, nutrients, and energy across the boundaries in an ecotone. Edges provide the connectivity of the two ecosystems by flow of energy, nutrients, and thus strongly influences the productivity of the ecosystem. The species found in the edges are known as species. So, the edge effect is the ultimate result of the formation of the ecotones naturally or artificially. And that edge effect are the main reason behind the increase in the edge species or artificial. Now the next one is the types of ecotone. If we see the types of ecotone, if that ecotone is formed naturally, then it is known as inherent ecotone. If the ecotone is formed because of anthropogenic or successional changes over time, that is known as induced ecotone. If the ecotone is very smaller in transition area, then it is known as narrow ecotone. Example is agricultural field. Another one is the wide ecotone. When the transition zone is very large, it may depend upon the physical factors and the vegetation cover. Example, forest and lake. The fifth one is the convoluted ecotone, where the ecotone is very non-linear. It is not in a single line. It is in zigzag form or it is non-linear in fashion. And the sixth one is the ecotone, which are formed because of the transitional gaps having a different types of habitats. So ultimately, mainly there are these six types of ecotone that are found in our earth in different places, and it makes the particular landscape a huge biodiversity area. This biodiverse area is also known as the hotspot of a particular ecosystem. Why it becomes the hotspot? Because it presents high biological diversity and can act as habitat for species under favorable conditions like climates, anthropogenic impacts, and natural disasters. Also, it has the high rate of primary and secondary production, which contributes to the system integrity and results in the production of high energy. It also provides a good spot for observation of natural communities. As the ecotones are highly diverse in nature, so it becomes a very good spot for observation of all types of communities that are found in between these two ecotones. Another term, that is ecocline, it is there. The ecotone is very much associated with the ecoclines, and sometimes people may get confused what are ecotone and ecoclines. Ecotones are associated with the ecoclines, and the ecocline is the physical transition zone. These ecocline transitions are very less distinct. They have high stability with compared to the ecotone, and thus have high species richness. It is the zone of gradual and continuous change from one ecosystem to another, and there is a minor difference in terms of species composition. So in ecoclines, mostly when we say about that, the differences in terms of species composition with respect to the two ecosystems is very less. The differences are very minor. Whereas in terms of ecotones, that is very higher. Whereas in terms of ecocline, it is very less. The ecoclines that occurs in between two ecosystems, because of the certain physical transition or the physical factors, or known as the abiotic factors like temperature, which is also known as thermocline, salinity or halocline, altitude, depth, density of water or peaknocline are the main regions behind the formation of this physical transition zone or ecoclimes. Next is the measurements of the ecotone. How can we measure the ecotone? The ecotones can be rarely delimited by a fine line. It is very difficult to measure a particular ecotone. Their measurement and mapping is not simple. Nowadays, a wide range of research approaches and tools have been used to detect and quantify ecotones. This includes the simulation modeling, geographical information systems, remote sensing, and statistical tools. Mostly the mathematical modelings we are preparing. Nowadays, different types of models that are prepared by using mathematical calculations. Then geographical information system that we are collecting from the satellites. Remote sensing. By using different remote sensing technique, we can check the ecotone area. And the statistical tools, on the basis of statistical data, we can compare the two or three ecosystems and the transition zones. We can enable quantification and analysis of ecotones of different types and over several spatial scales on which it is found, that area where it is found, their altitude, their coverage, their type of vegetations are the main source of measurements of ecotone. The patterns of biodiversity in ecotone. When we discuss about the diversity in ecotones, it is very high actually. In terms of ecotone, being it is the transition zone, it holds the high biological diversity over several spatial scales at both the community level. If we examine their species richness, that is a high number of species can be found in a particular ecotone. And at the within species level also, if we check the or observe their morphological and the genetic diversity, the biodiversity in ecotones are a bit higher. Another observation that high species richness and abundance in ecotones and the ecotonal community commonly contains are the many species that are characteristics are restricted to ecotone. Mainly whatever the species that is found, it has been observed in an ecotone that they are having some special characteristics. For example, the areas nearer to transitions between ecoregions had more bird species and also scored more highly in terms of species rarity. The rareness is more. And the next is the importance of ecotone. Why these ecotones are so important? Because it provides landscape function, seed dispersal and animal movement across the two different ecosystems. Also, they act as indicators of the climatic shift. It has the high rate of primary and secondary production and thus contributing to the system integrity. Also, the riparian, coastal and lacustrine ecotones transmit nutrients of water to aquatic ecosystems and turns back. The study of ecotones has led to a better understanding of the potential importance of speciation. Ecotones have been proposed to be centers of evolutionary process. As such, ecotones and areas of environmental transitions where evolutionary processes and barriers to gene flow can be examined. And this is the reason why the ecotones are known as natural laboratory. Also, the Ecotones are the area where energy and material exchanges are at a maximum in a heterogeneous landscape. In terrestrial systems, they correspond with the changes that is occurring in the soil, vegetation, and in the heterogeneous systems, they are situated at the patch edges in the form of structural community. It is found at all scales, both temporal and spatial. The importance of ecotone can be compared as cell membranes. The structures and the functions are almost similar in their action. The previous ecological measures considered archetypal terrains, mostly interiors, but understanding of landscape ecology shows the importance of boundaries between the two ecosystems. And next is the hierarchy of ecotone. It can be described on the basis of two phenomena. The first one is the spatial distribution, and the second one is the temporal distribution. The spatial distribution is the distribution of population in the different spaces. Mostly the ecotonal species are found in the transition zone. It may be the biomes, and it may found within the patches in a biomes. Also, it may be found within the different shape and size of the internal patches. And the population can be divided, or it may be distributed in the different transition of patches. Also, population may be divided into different patchy distribution. And the individuals at the lower level, for example, trees are found with localized water conditions or the water quality. And in case of the temporal phenomena, it is related to the time. The population that is found in terms of millions of years, which results in the climatic shift that is changing the species distribution, or it may be changing because of the movement of the human civilization, or it may change because of the river dynamics, or it may be changing because of the flooding regimes that may occur within a decades. Also, it is found to be seasonal, maybe because of the availability of water or the snow melting in the glaciers. And the management of ecotone, that another very important part of this ecotone. How can we manage the ecotone? It may be external or internal. The external, it includes the edaphic, microclimate, and the anthropogen. Because of the edaphic factors, microclimate, climatic change in the local level, and the anthropogenic, the various human activities. Then another one is the internal, that can be species-specific or more broad-based. Either it may be internal, within the species there may be certain changes that can be done by using this external and internal courses. Another one is the allelopathy. The ecotones, it is affected or it is managed by one type of species in contact with them to limit invasion of other species or leads to growth of other species. One species is there, when it is supporting another species, growth of the other species, then it is known as allelopathy. So that is also another effect of the management, it is occurring in a particular ecotone. Then the reproductive aggressiveness. Certain plants are there which are growing very aggressively, and also known as invasive species also. It may limit seeding of other plants. Certain grasses are there, some of the small herbs plants and climbers are there which grows more frequently and more easily in that particular area, and it may leads to the growth of the stop the growth of the other species. Another type of management of ecotone can be occurs because of the sediment capture from wind in the dune areas, that is in the desert, or in the water riparian by certain species after microbial invasion. That also can change the nutrient cycle. The animal activity like grazing, digging, seed predation, forest clearance play a vital role in the management of the ecotone. Example, tree destruction by elephant, it creates sravi ecotones. The most internal factors that still driven by external factors like the moss may change the value of pH, but external condition must still favor its growth initially. So this is how the management of ecotone. Next is the characters of ecotone. If you see the characters of ecotone, it also can be found in different forms. First one is the gradual, which is very common in nature, such as transition that occurs from grassland to woodland. The second one is the discontinuous. It is very common where a species reaches tolerance limit. That tolerance limit because of the salinity, temperature, pollutants, water levels, or other biological competitions. So at that time, the character is known as the discontinuous. Next one is the hysteretic, which is based upon the state of a particular ecotone or the state of a particular zone. Generally, it occurs where there is some degree of latency or some problems or weakness is there in the particular ecosystem. That weakness or that certain lacuna may result in the formation of hysteretic ecotone. These ecotones also multiple responses are there. Multiple response characters can be found in ecotone. It is common where other characters are also relevant. Sometimes it may be gradual, discontinuous. Many other characters are also present, and in those places, the multiple response characters of ecotones are found. Or where there is a complex evolutionary, certain evolutionary processes is going on, or historical relationship is there. So in such places, the multiple response characters of ecotone can be found. So after the characters of ecotone we have discussed, now the roles of ecotone and edge effect. The ecotones having their major role in the modification of the direction of movements between the landscape components. For example, riverine woodland increases field stability for agriculture, and at the same time it provides habitat for the insects that feed on crops. Also, another role is that it reduces the negative impacts of wind and some disturbances on patches, and it modifies the soil as well as its character. The edge effect generally increases biodiversity, but it is not for all species, and so may act as refugia for certain species. For example, birds may roost in forest ecosystem, but they can feed in ecotones. It is easier to predict overall biodiversity by examining the ecotone density in a particular ecotone. The greatest biodiversity occurs with the optimal blend of patches and ecotones. So if we see the ecotone density of the ecotone, it can be described as the biodiversity of the species or the population. It can be found in a different ecotonal region. If we see in the figure 6, the biodiversity, it is at lower when the frequency of ecotones are low, means lower in ecotone numbers. But as the frequency of ecotone, it increases up to the optimal mix of patches and edge habitat, the biodiversity attains its highest number. Simultaneously, as the frequency of ecotones, it reaches the higher frequency of ecotones, then their landscape fragmentation it occurs. When landscape fragmentation occurs, it expatriates the interior spaces and disturbs the species integrity, and ultimately it's lower down the biodiversity. Ecotone density can play a major role in determining the biodiversity of the ecotone, and the disturbances that are found in a particular ecotone because of its sizes and numbers. Since ecotones may be edges of species tolerance, rain shifts can be observed here first. Ecotones mainly used to study the different types of vegetation shift that occurs in two different ecosystems. Also, the ecotones is showing different fragility or different characters, we can say. For example, in terms of mountain ecotones, it may show a very fast change, whereas in terms of riparian ecotone, it may show a slower changes. And ultimately, these ecotones are of different kinds because of their. Next is the very important relationship that we will be discussing about the ecological succession and ecotone. As we know, the ecotone is disturbance related and it exists in space, but often they become indistinct as time passes. It has been found that the ecotones, as it is formed because of certain disturbances, naturally or artificially, but within the passing of time, ecologically, the process it occurs, it becomes indistinct. And that process is known as ecological succession. For example, an ecotone between a forest and a field disappears if the field is abandoned and the succession allows a mature forest to develop over the entire area in a course of time. So ultimately, that the relationship between the ecological succession, it affects on the ecotone. Succession is a directional process. The dominant species play a central role in that process, mainly the pioneer community. Succession is initiated by a discrete disturbance. Always the succession, as we know, it is that occurs or it starts with certain disturbances, or nudation, which happens in a site to immigration and establishment, which results in the formation of new species in ecotones. So ultimately, the ecological succession is affecting the ecotone. Somewhere it decreases the growth of ecotone after a certain time. Competition among dominant and subdominant species serpents the boundary between serial stages, and later the results in the homogeneous characteristics of each individual stage. The dominance, biotic reaction and competition are the process that organize communities and the process of changes in an ecotone. So ultimately, that ecological succession, it leads to the process of changes in an ecotone. At last, we can say the values of Bhikkhotan, why they are so important, how we can find these ecotones in a particular area, and why it is necessary for the supporting of two ecosystems. Because if the productivity of a system is assured by the ecotones because of its diversity. The removal of ecotones was useful in terms of lagoons, marshes, woodland matrices, because it made the land available for other organisms, but has long-term effects in breaking nutrient water cycles. It may goes for a long time effect in the breakdown of the nutrient cycle or the water cycles. That's why the value of ecotones are more. In case of the large ecotones, marshes and river meanders are too expensive to recover. If one ecotone has been disturbed or it is somehow it is diminished, to recover it, it will be very expensive and it will take a very long time. Hence, it is very important to preserve these systems, preserve these ecotones, preserve these transition zones where the organisms are moving, and to act as functional entities, because it regulates the functional activity of a particular ecosystem, and it acts as the biodiversity refugia. And that's why the values of ecotones, it is important to preserve it, understand the ecotone, value the ecotone, and thus we can save this ecotone from disturbance, from interposing disturbance. If it is naturally, we have to observe it, we have to save it. So at last, we can understand the values of ecotone and how the ecotone and as effect, it implies an important factor in the diversity of a particular area. And thus, the topic ecotone and as effect is very important in terms of ecology. Further, we can learn more in depth by using these references. Some of the reference books, it is mentioned here, that we can follow. I would like to express my thanks to Zoological Society of Assam, an initiative towards students' digital learning facility. I like to express my special thanks and sincere gratitude to Professor Jogen Chandra Kalita for motivating me to present the topic on account of Zoological Society of Assam YouTube channel. I also thanks to Mandeep Raj sir for his valuable guidance during the entire process. Also, I am dedicating this presentation to my guide, Professor D.K. Sharma, all my teachers, students, and my family. At last, thank you everyone. Thank you for watching this PowerPoint presentation on ecotone and as effect. Please give your query or any feedback regarding the topic. Here is my communication info. You can communicate with me on the following informations. Thank you.